in this video, we're going to be having a look at 5 totally free Elementor add-ons that you could get for your WordPress website if you're using Elementor Page Builder. Also, as the bonus, if you stay till the end of this video, I'm going to show you how you could get a bunch of premium add-ons for Elementor, almost for free. 3 of the plugins that we're having a look at today are the plugins that give you additional widgets for your Elementor free. But 2 of them are about something different, and we're gonna start with a pretty fun one. But before we start reviewing the Elementor add-ons, let me introduce you the theme that I'm using today. So this theme is a free, absolutely free WordPress theme that was built with the help of Elementor Page Builder, so it's fully Elementor based. Here you can see the beautiful design. It's clean, it's minimalistic, it is functional, and it is absolutely free. You can get this theme absolutely for free if you follow the link in the description. So now let's dive right in and have a look at the first plugin that I have prepared for today. And this plugin is called Flexible Elementor Panel, and it allows you to make your Elementor workflow a lot more versatile because it allows you to undock the entire Elementor panel and make it draggable. This is something that some users might like or dislike about Elementor, that the panel with the settings and the elements is fixed to the left. And now with this plugin, you'll be able to change that and drag it around. And this plugin is absolutely for free. And you could also collapse it and resize it and enable the dark mode, which some people might really, really like. And also minimize the categories and even expand the panel. And also it moves the exit to dashboard button to a more convenient place. I think that this one is a really good one, and I'm really excited to check it out on my website. And I have installed this plugin on my website. This is a clean WordPress installation and doesn't have anything except for Elementor. You see that on the left we do not have any additional labels that tell us how we could access this plugin, so I assume we simply have to go to the Elementor editor. Alright, so the first thing that I see is this little button. This says exit, and this one is exit to dashboard, and once I click on it, it brings me back to my WordPress dashboard, to the page that I was editing. So now it makes it quicker to exit from the Elementor editor to the dashboard, which is a pretty good feature. Now, next one, I see this icon, which means I now can collapse the Elementor panel. Also, another icon that allows me to, I assume, to undock it right now, but it kind of doesn't allow me to do that. So let's go to the settings. So FEP settings. And we have to enable the draggable panel option to be able to grab this panel and move it around. Let's see how it works with the elements. Let's click on something. Yeah, there we go. So everything works perfectly. Everything is perfectly comfortable. Really nice. I really like it. So let's put it back there. So, and then it sits right there where it is supposed to be. Okay, really nice. Let's have a look what we have here. Flex grid for widgets. Minimize all categories with the right click. The skins. Light or dark orange or dark pink. Exit button options. So you see here you can set to what place you're actually going to be taken if you click on the exit button. Open in a new tab. So if it's going to open this page that is set over here in a new tab or not. According to widget options over there. And reset the panel position or size. Okay. So let's try and expand it now. Let's see how far we can go. Ah, that's pretty much it. So almost to the half of the page. Nice. And now when I've enabled the right-click collapse option, once I right-click on any of the tabs, they collapse simultaneously. So this one is pretty fun, and it makes working with the Elementor editor a little bit more comfortable. So if you're interested in having it, just check out the link in the description. The next Elementor add-on that we're having a look at today is called Anywhere Elementor. And what it allows you to do is to insert a shortcut, and in this way, insert the Elementor template anywhere on your website, literally anywhere where it is allowed to add text and shortcodes. There's also a pro version that gives you more advanced functionality, but now we're going to go and have a look at the free version of this plugin at my website. So once this plugin is installed and activated, on your left-hand sidebar, you're going to see the AE templates label. Once you click on it, you are taken to the menu where you can view the list of the already existing templates, if you have any, and where you can create a new one. Now we go and create a template. I'm just going to insert a simple gallery and the heading. Once I'm done creating this template, I'm going to go to any post that I have on my website, click edit, and in the Gutenberg editor, I'm going to add one more block, and there I'm going to insert the shortcode. There it is. Let's preview now. And as I scroll down a page, I see that in this particular post, at the very place where I have inserted the shortcode, now my Elementor template appears. It is extremely convenient because I can create sort of global templates and insert them in multiple places. And once I change this template, the change is going to be reflected everywhere, in every place where I have inserted this template. So this one is called Essential Add-ons for Elementor. And what it does is adds a number of widgets to your Elementor page builder. So if you scroll down, you could see the number of widgets that you get. So in the free version of this plugin, you get over 25 widgets. If you upgrade to the pro version, you get even more. Also, in addition, in the pro version, you get some special effects. And once we activate this plugin, you can see that it gives you a separate interface. So here you can report the bug, access documentation. So pretty much to work with this plugin, you get this label over here. Let's click on Elements, Label, and have a look at what widgets it actually gives us. So here you can see which widgets are available for you in the free version and which ones are pro. And you have global control, so we can enable and disable certain widgets, so you don't have them in the panel anymore if you disable them. All right, then extensions. So the extensions are simply the visual effects that could be added with the pro version. And in the tools, you can clear a cache. So it is pretty much simple and intuitive. Now what I'm going to do is to go and try and edit my homepage and try and see how I could use the widgets that this add-on gives me. So here, let's see if we can find the new widgets. And there we go. We have a separate tab, Essential Add-ons. Here they are. So we see we have data tables, countdowns, flip boxes. So some of them are just for the elements that are simply good looking. Some of them are really functional, such as pricing tables or post grids. So it doesn't look bad at all. Now let's try and see what we could do with the contact form. So right there, we select the contact form. Now let's see if we can do something with the pricing table. So it gives you the pre-made design right away. So in short, this is what you get in the free version of Essential Add-ons for Elementor. A number of 29 additional widgets for Elementor that work pretty nice. But as you know, the biggest disadvantage of the free plugins is that they do not provide the support in case of any issues. So if you're using free plugins, that is kind of risky, and you should be prepared that if something goes wrong, there is no one to come to the rescue and help you fix the situation on your website. So I guess we're done with the essential add-ons, and now it is time to move on to the next one, which is called Premium Add-ons for Elementor, which is actually a free plugin for Elementor page builder. So what you get here is over 22 Elementor widgets. There you have them. And also there is a possibility to go pro to get the pro version of this plugin. Let's check this out. I have disabled the essential add-ons, and now it's time to activate the premium add-ons. Here it is, and this plugin also gets its own label on the left side door menu. There it is. There's also the global control, so you can disable the widgets that you don't need, that you don't want to see in your Elementor panel. These are the pro elements that are not available in the free version, and also have Google Maps here, which is a possibility to set the API key, and this is how you're going to be able to display maps on your website. This is pretty nice. The version control and the system information, like this. So pretty much the same as with the essential add-ons, but I see that some of the elements are different. So now let's try and check them out in the Elementor editor. Here we are. And again, premium add-ons plugin gives you additional tab in here, and the new widgets are separated and they look a little bit different, so you're not going to get confused while choosing between the default Elementor widgets and the ones that go with premium add-ons plugin. So what is there? Also contact form, heading, grid, also testimonials, video box, which wasn't present in the essential add-ons. Now we had a look at a couple of widgets that go with the premium add-ons plugin for Elementor. This is a free plugin. If you want to get it, follow the link in the description under this video. And this one also adds additional widgets for Elementor page builder. This is called Live Mesh add-ons for Elementor. So this is also a sort of a freemium plugin. So you start with the free version. If you like it, you could go premium. So here is a list of the widgets that you get. It seems to me that it's a little bit smaller than in essential add-ons or premium add-ons for Elementor, but we're going to find out. So now let's go and activate it on my website. So it offers you to download an additional plugin that may be a partner of this one. In this case, you also get the sort of a control panel. So there is also a link to documentation and a way to contact the developer. So, and here you have some global settings, such as for default theme color and the hover color for your theme, like that. This is a pretty interesting option, might be really, really useful. So the elements, also global control, and you can deactivate the ones that you don't want to use. So in this case, what we have is 13 free elements that you get with this plugin. So these are pie charts, clients, pricing table, also testimonial, services portfolio. Okay, we'll see them later. Also, there is a chance to enter custom CSS for styling options, debugging, and the ability to go pro. All right, now let's check this out in Elementor. So 13 is almost 2 times fewer than we had with essential add-ons for Elementor, but they might be also pretty good. So here they are. It's team members, testimonials, statistics bars, odometers, pie charts, services heading. Also, the pricing table again. Let's check this out. This one doesn't give us any default design to start with. So we decide how many pricing plans in a row we want to have, and then we add one item. Now this is pretty interesting, because with two previous plugins, when they gave us the pricing table widget, it was like one panel, and then you had to copy these panels in one section in another column. But here what you do is you add plans here in one single widget and fill in the information right here. So this is a pretty interesting approach. I find it to be really comfortable. Let's have a look at the post carousel actually. This might be interesting. I hope I have enough posts to display here. All right. So this is how it works. And you can change the style apparently. Here are the settings. This actually looks pretty good. And I guess we're done with this particular plugin. And I remind you that it is called Live Mesh Add-ons for Elementor. It features 13 additional widgets, and you can get it if you follow the link in the description. So we have reviewed 5 of the free Elementor add-ons, and as I've promised, here is the bonus for all the viewers who have stayed till the end of the video. Probably the most popular and the most best-selling plugins for Elementor are Jet plugins. These are the ones that were acknowledged by Elementor team themselves for being super functional, for providing great support for the users, and constantly evolving and developing. The plugins in the Jet family are Jet Elements, Jet Menu, Jet Pop-Up, Jet Engine, which allows you to work with dynamic content, create custom post types, custom taxonomies, create calendar events, booking forms, and a lot more. Also Jet Woo Builder, that provides you with a set of tools to build astonishing online stores. And these tools are the ones that are not possible to find anywhere else. This is the perfect plugin if you want to work with Elementor and WooCommerce at the same time and achieve the best results possible. There are more of great Jet plugins, and there is a way to get them all in one single place, easy to access, easy to manage, and this way is to get them within Monstray 2 WordPress theme. This theme is known to be the most advanced and convenient tool for creating websites with WordPress and Elementor because it goes with a dozen of Jet plugins, almost 1,000 of pre-made pages and sections, dozens of gorgeous skins, and all of that is being constantly updated and supported by the developers. With Monstray 2, you are able to edit every single part of your theme, work with templates, headers and footers, and all of the widgets that you get in Jet plugins combined are almost 200 additional widgets for Elementor. Fast loading, flawlessly performing, and highly functional. Plus, as I have mentioned, all of that is supported 24/7 by the developers. So, and that was pretty much it for this video about free add-ons for Elementor. So, if you want to download any of the free plugins that were mentioned in this video, go check out the links in the description. And also, if you're interested in learning more about Monstray 2 or any of the Jet plugins, you can find the links to them also in the description. So, I hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching.